On a national level, we are trying to increase the number of engineers in the United States. And by doing that, it is critical to access every population that wants to be an engineer.
Penn State is one of the best engineering schools in the world.
We help someone achieve a goal that they've already set for themselves.
I am really passionate about the College of Engineering because it has helped me so much. Academia is their foundation, but they up the ante a bit by saying, okay, how do you make someone really, really successful?
It is academic, it is financial, and building community.
When I heard about the Women in Engineering program, it was the defining moment for why I chose Penn State. The program really prepares you for school, your future career.
Penn State's actually the only school that I applied to. I'm a first-generation college student. I accepted my full-time job offer with Boeing in Charleston, South Carolina, and I really just can't wait to get started.
My transition was pretty rough. Graduating, it seems so far away, but I'm so close now. It's been a long road, but I'm almost there, so I'm pretty happy.
Very often, the K-12 education system does not distribute education, I'll just say evenly, throughout the country. I can't fix that, but what I can do is provide all kinds of academic enhancements. So when they walk into September, they all enter on a level playing field.
Before freshman year, I was in the Summer Bridge program with an intensive math course, an intensive physics course, and an intensive chemistry course. It was really helpful. I think that was one of the main reasons I did so well my first semester.
It's helping them make the transformation from high school to the college level. But it's a little bit different, like the atmosphere is different, the pace is different.
If we feel supported and we have all that extra help, we're more likely to stick to the major versus students who haven't done the programs, haven't built that connection with other people.
I think it's really special to be a woman in engineering. You form really tight bonds and work together really nicely.
We are mentors, we're confidants, we're friends.
I'm working 20 hours a week. About half of those is just tutoring at the Academic Excellence Center, and about 10 of the other ones are working at the Engineering Diversity Office.
So in terms of financial support, we have access to a variety of scholarships, and so we provide a wide range of different kinds of financial tools that help students.
I receive financial aid based on need, and I also have a few that are academic or scholarly based. I have definitely had my struggles, but financial aid has been key.
All students are not the same, and so we provide a variety of programs to choose from. The Engineering Mix is a program particularly for students who are seeking professional development.
I had a really great mentor when I was a freshman, and so I took on the mentorship role. And three of my sophomore women that I mentored are now three of my closest friends. So it's a really good like relationship jump starter, and I love them to death. I can't wait to see them succeed.
MEP and WEP nights, those are monthly events where the research shows that when students form long-term community, it is a difference in going forward or not. If you think there are very few women in engineering, at the graduate level, there are even fewer. And the issues of isolation are even bigger.
So it's not just like they prepare you for it and then they just leave you. No, they are with you through the whole time as a resource to call on.
We graduate more undergraduates than any other institution in the nation. We are always in the top 10 for the numbers of women bachelor's degrees that we give out in the nation.
I don't think that I would have finished engineering school as successfully as I had without the program. Not only did it teach me the tools I needed at the very beginning, but it also gave me all of those women as my support system.
One thing I've learned is that when you give to the next generation, you change the future. When you contribute to the programs that make these students successful, you've changed the future.
Engineering is a really tough discipline. So to stick through it, you need to have a sense of confidence and you need that support backing you up.
Everyone who's on.
When you give a student a college degree, you change the game for who that person is and what that person can become and who they will inspire.
I am a team leader for the Alcoa recruiting organization, so talent is key for us. When we look for engineers for our company, we lean to Penn State Engineering.
Our company believes that diversity is needed in the workplace because if we don't shift with the demographics, we won't have enough people to support our engineering needs in the future.
When I first started in the College of Engineering, there weren't a lot of women. And I look at the young women and the minority students coming in today, they got it. And I think a lot of that is because schools like Penn State have become kind of a change agent of pushing that nationally.
Everything counts, whether it's funding, whether it's a kind word, whether it's encouragement, whether it's coming back to tell a student, I used to be you. It makes a difference. And I believe that's important.